Hello everyone, so in this lecture we'll see some theorems related to equivalence relation. Okay, so guys, let us begin with some theorems in equivalence relation. Okay, so write down first theorem, that is what? Theorem number one. So this theorem says that corresponding to every partition, corresponding to every partition that is pi of a set A, there exists a unique equivalence relation whose quotient set is exactly the partition pi. That is the first theorem, isn't it? So this theorem says that corresponding to every partition pi of a set A, there exists a unique equivalence relation whose quotient set is exactly the partition pi. So let us consider one question, and based on that we'll see. Yes. Okay. So let us consider one example. Let's say, consider one partition. Let's say one partition is given that is 1, 2, then 3 and 4. Let's say this is a partition of a set. Let's say that is 1, 2, 3, 4. So one set is given that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the partition of the given set. Now, question is what? Let's say find out the equivalence relation corresponding to the above partition. Isn't it? Also, check whether the quotient set that is A by R, quotient set of set A induced by the equivalence relation R, is pi or not. So here we can see, yes, here partition is given, that is partition is given, that is we can say that 1, 2, 3 and 4, this is the partition. Now you only tell me what will be the equivalence relation. Equivalence relation, that is capital R. Yes, how to find this equivalence relation? That will be, yes, we can say that here, let's say this is A1, this is A2, and this is A3. So, yes, find out A1 cross A1, union with A2 cross A2, union with A3 cross A3. Now, you only tell me, if we do, yes, union of all these Cartesian products, then we will get a relation that is 1, 1, 1, 2, then we can say that 2, 1, then 2, 2, then 3, 3, and 4, 4. Now you can check this one is the equivalence relation. This is the equivalence relation. So we can say that this relation, you can see this one is transitive as well as reflexive and symmetric. That's why this is equivalence relation. So the statement of the theorem says that corresponding to every partition of a set A, there exists a unique equivalence relation. So you can see that this partition was given, and corresponding to this partition, one equivalence relation is existing. This one is the equivalence relation. Isn't it? Now, next part of the theorem is whose quotient set is exactly the partition pi. Now, This equivalence relation is there. Now find out the quotient set of this equivalence relation, and we'll see that quotient set will be exactly same as the partition, isn't it? Okay. So moving to the yes, this relation is what we can say that this one is 1, 1, 1, 2, then 2, 1, then 2, 2, then 3, 3. And then 4, 4, isn't it? That is the relation, that is equivalence relation. Now find out the quotient set for this relation. So what will be the quotient set? We can say that union of all equivalence classes. All these things are related to previous lectures. So first was previous lectures, isn't it? Okay. So we can say that equivalence class of 1 will be what? That is 1, 2. Yes, we already discussed in the previous lectures. 1 is related with 1 as well as 2. Similarly, equivalence class of 2 will be 1, 2. Similarly, equivalence class of 3 will be the 3 only, because 3 is related only with 3. And equivalence class of 4 will be the 4 only. Isn't it? So we can say that quotient set. Quotient set means A by R. A by R means quotient set of A induced by the relation equivalence relation R. That will be the union of, we can say that, all these equivalence classes. Now union of all these equivalence classes, you can see this one is the, yes, given partition. This is equal to the given partition or not? Yes or no? So that was the second part of the theorem. Hence, we can say that quotient set, that is A by R, is equal to or exactly the partition pi. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Okay. So, next theorem, yes, write down next one. That is, let's say, theorem number 2. This theorem says that R is an equivalence relation. Equivalence relation if and only if R inverse is an equivalence relation. If and only if means biconditional, means we can say that in both ways. If R is equivalence, then R inverse will also be equivalence, and conversely, if R inverse is equivalence, then R will also be equivalence. That is the meaning of if and only if. And you can easily, yes, verify this theorem, you know very well. Why? Because we can say that I already discussed all these things, because R is an equivalence relation. We can say that is a relation that is reflexive, symmetric, as well as transitive. And you know very well R is a reflexive. Yes, if and only if R inverse is a reflexive. Yes, we already discussed this one. Similarly, we can say that R is symmetric. Yes, if and only if R inverse is symmetric. Similarly, we can say that R is transitive. If and only if R inverse is transitive. So because of that, we can say that yes, R is an equivalence relation if and only if R inverse is an equivalence. Next theorem, theorem number 3. This theorem says that a relation R is a partial order relation. Partial order relation. If and only if R inverse is partial order relation. Partial order relation. The reason is what? Why? Because we already discussed this one. R is reflexive if and only if we can say that R inverse is reflexive. Isn't it? Next one, we can say that R is antisymmetric if and only if R inverse is antisymmetric. And similarly, we can say that R is transitive if and only if R inverse is transitive. Isn't it? That's why we can say that yes, Yes, R is partial order if and only if R inverse is the partial order, isn't it? Okay. Next one is theorem number 4. That this theorem says that if R and S are equivalence relations on same set, then R intersection S is also an equivalence relation. But R union S may or may not be an equivalence relation. Isn't it? Okay. Why? Because the reason is what? We can say that R and S are equivalence relations on same set, an intersection of these will be an equivalence relation, but union may or may not be an equivalence relation. Why? Because R and S both are equivalence. That means R is what? Reflexive, symmetric, as well as transitive. And you can see, yes, intersection of two reflexive relations will be reflexive only, and intersection of two symmetric will be symmetric only, and intersection of two transitive relations will be transitive only. But in case of union, we can see union of two reflexive relations will be, yes, reflexive, no problem at all. Symmetric, or we can say that union of symmetric will be symmetric only. But remember, union of two transitive relations may not be transitive. Yes, we will take one example and verify this result. Yes, okay. So you can see that the region is what? Yes, I will take one example also. No need to worry at all. So the region is that we can say that the intersection of two reflexive relations is reflexive, intersection of two symmetric relations is symmetric, and intersection of two transitive relations is transitive, isn't it? That's why we can say that. So we can say that, let's say, yes, this is a reflexive, then this is symmetric, then that is, we can say that, transitive, and next one we can say that equivalence. So R and S are the equivalence relation. So yes, intersection of R and S will be, or if both are reflexive, then intersection will also be reflexive. If both are symmetric, then we can say that intersection will also be symmetric. If R and S both are transitive, then intersection will also be transitive. That's why we can say that if R and S are equivalence, then we can say that intersection will also be an equivalence relation. Similarly, if R and S are reflexive, then union will also be reflexive. Yes, if both are symmetric, then the union will also be symmetric. But if both are, we can say that if both are transitive, then union may not be transitive. That's why it may not be equivalence relation, isn't it? So let us take one example, and with the help of example, we will verify this particular theorem. Okay, so let us consider one example. Let's say, yes, you can see, let us consider one example, one relation is, let's say, reflexive, 1, 1, then 2, 2, then 3, 3, and let's say 2, comma 3. This is on A, and let's say set A is 1, 2, 3. Let us consider two reflexive relations, let's say on same set. Isn't it? So you can see if both are reflexive on A, then R intersection S, that will be what? Reflexive only. That is the meaning. So intersection will also be a, we can say that reflexive relation. So in this manner, you can verify each and every, isn't it? Intersection will be of two reflexive, will be reflexive. Yes, we can say that intersection of two symmetric relations will be symmetric relation. And similarly, we can say that intersection of two transitive relations will be transitive only. But problem is where we can say that union of two transitive relations may not be transitive. So let us consider one more example on that. Let's say one relation is given, that is 1, 2, then 2, 3, then 1, 3 on set A, where A is 1, 2, 3. And one more relation S is given, that is 2, 3, 3, 2, 2, 2, that is also on A. So we can say that both relations are on same set, and you can see these are transitive as well. One is related with 2, 2 is related with 3, so 1 is related with 3. 2 is related with 3, 3 is related with 2, then 2 is related with 2. Yes, both are transitive. Now let us take the union of both these. So union will be 1, 2, then 2, 3, then 1, 3, yes, 2, 3, then 3, 2, and 2, 2. Isn't it? So union, we can say that is the union, R union S. Now you only tell me, if this one is the union, now this relation union is transitive or not. Here we can say that here, let's say, yes, we can say that 1 is related with 2, 2 is related with 3, so 1, 3 must present. Yes, 1, 3 is present, isn't it? Next one, you can see 1, 2, 3 and 3, 2, 2, so 1, 2 must be present. Yes, that is present, yes or no? Next one, you only tell me, here 3 is related with 2, that is X, this is Y, and Y is related with Z, so X must be related with Z, that means 3, 3 must present, then only we can say that this is transitive, yes or no? But here we can say that 3, 2 is present, as well as we can say that 3, 2 is present and 2, 3 is present, so this is X, this is Y, this is Y, this is Z. So because of transitivity, X, Z must be present, that is 3, 3 must be present. But you can see here 3, 3 is not there. That's why we can say that this relation is not transitive. This relation is not transitive. So we can say that yes, union of two transitive relations may not be transitive. That's why we can say that union of two equivalence relations may not be equivalence relation. Okay. So that's all about, we can say that relations. So we covered, yes, we covered in the set theory, we covered sets, relations and functions. So that's all about relations, isn't it? So in the next lecture, we will start what is partial ordering, what are lattices, isn't it? Different types of lattices, isn't it? And extremal elements of lattices, let's say least upper bound, greatest lower bound, all these things we will be, yes, covering in the next coming lectures. And after that, we'll start group theory, isn't it? And after group theory, we will be having the lectures on graph theory. That will be the last part on the discrete mathematics. Okay. I hope this one is clear to everyone. Thank you so much.